This episode is brought to you by Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor stars as Count Alexander Rostov in A Gentleman in Moscow, the new limited series based on the best-selling novel. Stream it with the Paramount Plus with Showtime plan. Visit ParamountPlus.com to try it free.
Y'all already know what time it is. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Today is prison talk, and I got some things to say. And if you are watching and you was locked up and you want to tap in, feel free to tap in. Make sure that you... Sorry, I was getting a phone call. Denied. Okay. If you would like to talk about your time on a yard, even if you haven't sent me a picture to get your flyer made, that doesn't matter. You can actually tap in on the live. Y'all already know what time it is. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. Okay? 8 Central Time. And you just never know when I'm going to end, because sometimes I end at 9, sometimes I end at 10, sometimes 11, sometimes 12. You just never know. The vibes be so good, you just never know. Okay? So, I'm going to go ahead and get my song started, and I'm going to go ahead and share the live. So if you're watching on Facebook, make sure you hit the like button and share the live. And if you're watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. Y'all already know what time it is. It's the Couch Chronicles. And it ain't no fucking limits. And it is prison talk.
We hit the jackpot this time.
Let me make sure I share the live. Hey, wifey, I love you.
Big time, I did big time. Giving up the mirrors, they took me straight off the front line. I'm not lying. I'm watching my mama cry up in that courtroom. Then the judge just dismissed me like I was dumb too. Then the bailiff looked at me like, what you gonna do? My mind is fucked up, so all I'm thinking is I'm gonna shoot. And reality set in like it was supposed to. Cat calls down the hall, that's what them folks do. Brown bag, bologna sandwich in them jumpsuits. My cellmate just did 100 years on some dumb shit. Damn, is this the end of the days? Cause living in this hell is just like being in a grave. If ain't no money on your books, then you ain't eating shit. You better pray that you can mail a penitentiary gift. For them lonely days, a visitation list from your family and your friends, that's a major lift. And yo, spirit, hey, all the drama on the
yard.
Come
on in, if you're watching on Facebook, share the live.
Yeah. Behind these walls is different, and you wouldn't understand if you didn't live it. Hey, big time, I did big time. Hey, and they took me off the front line. I'm still scarred from doing my time. And everybody said I should let go. I'm trying, but it did something to my mental. In or out the pen, you know I stand 10 toes. Now you know, I hold my own, that ain't wrong, and I know I gotta think different, cause if I don't, then I guess I'll be the same nigga. Wait, I'm trying to let it go, I'm trying to be a better person so I don't have to get physical. I gotta get my mind right for
y'all, come on in and share.
I don't care who's judging if they don't know doing time. I'm trying to be an example to my fans and all my peoples and my nieces. Big time, I did big time. Sitting in the cold cell in the daytime. Your time be fine, but it's not like the world, no. Big time, I did big time. Giving up them years, they took me straight off the front line. I'm not lying. I'm watching my mama cry up in that courtroom. Then the judges dismissed me like I was dumb too. Better look at me like, what you gon' do? My mind is fucked up, so all I'm thinking is I'm gon' shoot. Damn, is this the end of the day? Cause swimming in the cell is just like being in the grave.
Hey, y'all already know what time it is. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. It's prison talk today. I wrote down some stuff to talk about because a lot of times we don't talk about the people that passed away, that was locked up. Okay, YouTube, you know my vibe. So we don't get to talk about people that we lost on the yard. So I wrote down some names. Now, I didn't get to write down every name because it's a lot of people that passed away that was locked up. But I did write down some names, and I want to mention them today. So if you was locked up, even if you wasn't locked up with me, if you a male or a female and you was locked up and you want to talk about your time, this whole week is prison talk. Feel free to tap in on the live. Feel free to send me a picture for the flyer. Like, it's all about getting the word out and the message out. And the only way that the message is going to get out is if we talk about it. You know what I'm saying? So we got to talk about it. So that's the only way it's going to get out. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit the like button. If you're watching on Facebook, make sure that you share the live. It's Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. Follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok. Couch Chronicles dot No Limits on Instagram. And my main YouTube and Instagram is THA Real JANELL. You can also visit my.com and it also has the couch information up there as well. A whole link for the couch. So make sure that you follow, support. It's all about love, support, good vibes, and positive energy. Anybody that comes to the podcast, make sure that you love, support, and share their shit too. It's all about that. Love, support, good vibes, and positive energy. I'm just saying. Yes. So I'm going to start off by naming some people. I'm not going to name the whole list right away. I'm going to start at the top of the names that I wrote down. And then I'm going to play some music. And then we're going to talk about some of the times on the yard that I did. Like I said, feel free to tap in if you did any time and you want to talk about it. Don't just let me keep on talking. Y'all ain't got to just listen to me. If you want to talk about it too, you can tap in. So the first person that I'm going to mention that passed away is Chelsea Watson. And I got to smoke to this. And I said her name first because we was very tight. When she passed away, I took it real hard. I actually, I lost 3 friends in 1 week, and it started with Chelsea. And then it was like, fuck. And then like a couple years later, I lost 2 friends all in the same week. And it was, I lost it, you know. I know what she was going through. And every time she got a chance, I don't give a fuck if she was high on drugs, whatever. She would call me wherever I'm at and she's like, oh my God, friend, I'm listening to your music right now. And so I'm so thankful that before she passed away, I was able to sing to her all the time. I have good memories with her. Not just from the penitentiary. Like, when we got out, we was hanging out, going to lunch dates, and keeping each other lifted. A lot of times when you get out, we don't know, and I'm saying we because I was there too. We don't know how to be in the world. I know it sounds crazy. Because we want to get there so bad. But we don't know how to be in the world and be in society and be like a regular person, if that's what you would call it. Because we so stuck in the penitentiary ways, not even on purpose. Like, it just happens. Like, sometimes you find yourself being institutionalized and you like, oh my God, like, I told myself I was never gonna be like this. But that's just the cold facts. So I literally took her death bad. Like, I was drinking and driving. Right. See? Wow. See, I know it's called being a civilian. I know that. But when people that was locked up, y'all already know it's prison talk. Y'all know what talk I'm talking. When you out in the world, okay? When you out in the world, It's totally different. We don't know how to be no civilian, none of that. It was hard, especially after doing 9 years. I was like, when I went in, it was still Black Planet MySpace. So when I got out, it was touch screens and all of this shit. We still had motherfucking pagers when I went in. So I'm getting out and they don't have none of that shit. So I'm like, what am I supposed to be doing, by the way? Am I supposed to tell the people that I'm trying to work for that I'm a that I just got out of prison, or how do we do this? It was really stressful for me. So when Chelsea passed away, I literally had just spoke to her a week before. And so, hey, wifey, I see you. I see you. I love you. We had literally just got done talking. And maybe like a week later, she passed away. Her friend that she had called me with the first time had hit me up and was like, I want you to know that Chelsea's dead. I was like, what? Like, we can't be talking about the same Chelsea. Not my Chelsea. My Chelsea's dead? And she confirmed it. And I just, oh my God. Like I said, I was drinking and driving. And don't ever do it. Like, I was going through so much that I didn't give a fuck about nothing. And my wife did everything she could to, like, lift me up and try to keep my spirits up. But I was just so, it was like right after Chelsea. Then my friend, he passed away. And then my friend died from lupus. And then I was just like, oh my God, I'm next. Like, I was thinking all type of shit. Like, what the fuck? So, you know, Chelsea Watson. I still send her messages on Facebook. Sometimes, you know, when her birthday comes around, I still... I'm sorry, y'all. My girl, though. But, sometimes I go to her page, like when I drop a new song. Because I know how she felt about my music, and I know, you know what I'm saying, like, I know she's smiling down at me. We even had a song that we listen to all the time. And sometimes whenever I take shrooms, that song will randomly come on. And I know she's trying to reach me. I know she's talking to me. Like, I know she like, keep going, friend. Keep going. Like, don't stop. And I'm not. That was my girl, man. She was a really good person. And when I didn't, when my family couldn't send me money when I was in the county and I was in lock, the whole time she took care of me, she was like, tell them don't send you nothing. I got you. I'm going to get you a box. She got me a box every week. I was so fat because of her. She got me a box every time. Boy, we was always in lock together. One time I was in there. I was back there for some bullshit. And she got into a fight with somebody just to come back there with me. And she was like, friend, and I made it back. Fucking Chelsea. She was like, but I think I got my ass whooped because I slipped and fell. She said, but I was whooping her fucking ass at first. I fucking love Chelsea. Man. So I was looking in the Mabel Bassett, Eddie Warriors group, and I seen an old video of hers, you know, and it just brings me to tears, because that's y'all know how it is when you get close to somebody and they just like your family to you, you know what I mean? She wanted the best for me, for real. Buttercup, do y'all remember Buttercup? Oh my God, Buttercup was dope as fuck. Like, the bonds that we used to have in prison, and I still have some of those same bonds with y'all. Like, I love y'all so much. Like, y'all are literally my family. Right. Oh, yes. I got her name on here too. Dakota. You talking about Dakota? Slim. Slim passed away as well. If you remember anybody's name that we was locked up with that passed away, mention their name. Mention their name. Make them our fucking Breonna Taylors, our motherfucking George Floyds. Like, say their name. Chelsea Watson, Buttercup, Patches. Y'all remember Patches? Boy, Patches used to always be on them pills, didn't she? Patches used to love them rides. Boy, she sent them rides too. Patches was the shit. And man, we lost a lot of beautiful people on the yard. We really did. Oh man, Papa Lasky. Oh, I'm so sorry. Whew. Oh man, this is, I didn't realize this was gonna make me so emotional. Whew. Because I was so close to these people. I'm talking about starting from the county to my sentence. Yep, Destiny Popolowski. So, I had no clue I was going to get this emotional. All I know is we need to say their names. Yes, Shirley Squirt Jones. Yes. We need to say their names. We need to mention them. We need to keep their memory alive because we will want somebody to keep ours alive. A lot of them missed a lot of time being in the world. So they don't have nobody that just really was just like mentioning their name or remembering them because they missed so much. But we didn't miss it. We was there with them. You know? I'm trying to. Nita Rita. Nita Rita, she was also like, I was in the choir. I didn't want to be in the choir, I'm not gonna lie. And she kept saying, girl, you better use that voice for the Lord. You better use that voice. I'm gonna be right here in front of you. I'm gonna be right here beside you singing. And she was. She was. She was. Y'all, make sure y'all say their name. Remember these people. These people meant something to all of us. And I know that they meant something to their family. So imagine being this close to them. You know what I mean? And you're not their family. Okay? Like, imagine what they going through. I can only imagine. Because they didn't just die yesterday. But it still bothers me. It still hurts my heart. Like, fuck. Jamise was my girl too. Yep. Shonda 6ix9ine Jefferson. Yeah. Stephanie Wiley. Amber Himberlin. Like, I need to take a drink. And it's the fact that some of these deaths are murders. You know what I mean? They're not just, they wasn't just deaths. Some of them was murdered on the yard. You know what I'm saying? And there's nothing we can do about it except talk about it. Jennifer Polite. Yes. Oh my gosh, she was so fun. Like, mention their names, y'all. If you know anybody, if you remember anybody that passed away, I'm still going through the list. I just can't get past these fucking tears. Teresa T-Pain Payne. Yeah. I just, listen. I don't want to pass away and y'all don't remember me. I want y'all to mention me. I want y'all to remember
You know what I mean? I want us to all to remember each other. I don't remember because guess what? When we go to the next life, we was remembering so much that we gonna remember each other in the next life. You know what I'm saying? I know, Candace. Amanda Lane. We still do rallies in front of Mabel Bassett. You know what I'm saying? In the name of Amanda Lane as well. In the name of Amanda Lane as well. Y'all, we gotta take a stand. You know what I mean? We gotta be the ones. We gotta be the voice. Because some of them is scared to get on here and talk. They don't want to get in trouble. But they want their message to get out. And I do too. So, I'm gonna do it every month. Every month. Until I die, I don't give a fuck. Until my podcast is over with and I don't ever do my podcast again. I'm always doing prison talk. I spent half of my life in that bitch. Like, and some of y'all have too, you know. I still get emotional thinking about the shit that happened on the yard. You see it? Like, it says Amanda was a fellow juvenile who looked out for me. She was a good person. All of these people were good. Like, Elizabeth Jenkins, Liz. I don't care, like, what we went through on the yard, what we went through out. I never would wish death or would want that until it's natural and it's just your time. But to just, it's somebody's name I can't remember, but I know her face. Her face is like in my head. And oh my gosh, she used to fight a lot, but she was really sweet. But she just was, I can't remember. I want to say her name. I don't want to say Tuesday because I don't think that was her name, but I think it might have been Megan. Yeah, Skittles as well. CC Murphy, Sierra Nicole Murphy. Yo. You know, in the history that I have with some of these people, it's kind of hard. You know what I'm saying? I don't really remember, like, having no day ones or nothing like that. But I remember, like, the people that I was in DHS custody with. The people that I was in juvenile with. I was in prison with them, too. You know what I mean? And so, it hits a little different. It hits a little different. It hits a little different when you know them from the world, and then you went, it just hits a little different too. Chartel. Yeah, Chartel. Oh my God, Chartel. Man. Red. Y'all remember Red? Amanda Smith. Yvette Kennedy. Karina Harjo. Ooh, I'm trying to keep it together. I gotta get on another song. Y'all, if you just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I swear I did not know that I was gonna be this emotional. Ooh. I didn't know. This is embarrassing. Oh, this is, whoa. If you're watching on Facebook, make sure you share the live. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit the like button. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. It's prison talk. It got me emotional today. Man.
gotta remember our people.
And I know it's really hard to keep your head up, and you've been working every day to get your bread up. It's even lonely at the top, and now you're fed up. This shit is crazy, you look through, but you can't make this shit up. Supposed to always tell the truth. I cross my heart and hope to die. This shit is crazy. What I go through, I can't make this shit up.
No, I can't make this shit up.
I would have never worn no makeup. Right. It is sad. Dina Smurf. Yes. I don't know if y'all remember Candy Boy, but she made a really big impact in my life because, you know, we was during Juneteenth and we used to, I don't know if y'all remember when we used to stomp the yard in that bitch, like, man. Pam, Phyllis Stacks, Phyllis. Oh my God, like Sharon McLean, Christina Gardner, Starla. Man, y'all. Say they names. Say they names. If you was locked up with somebody and you know that they passed away, mention their name. Like, mention their name like they somebody that was in the world and they lost their life. You know what I'm saying? Like, and some of them did lose their life in this world. But guess what? They didn't really have that. They didn't get a chance to build them connections with people. You know what I mean? Because a lot of times when you locked up, do you think a lot of those people keep in touch? Do you think that people, a lot of them weren't getting no visits? A lot of them, their family wasn't, you know what I'm saying? Because they couldn't, not because they didn't want to, but because they couldn't. So imagine getting out, not even being out a week or a month or a year, even a year. And you didn't get a chance to build a bond with anybody. And nobody mentions you. I'm so glad we got the Mabel Bassett Eddie Warriors group because y'all so good at keeping up with people that do pass away. And it also, because I don't watch the news. I watch the groups. So, you know, I love that y'all keep your ear to the streets. You know what I'm saying? For people like me that don't watch TV or watch the news. I don't watch the news for a reason. I just don't. All the ladies that lost their life, I want to do like a, you know, when you go to Oklahoma City to the bombing and they got like the, you know,
where you put the, I think it's a lock. Do they put locks there, or was it a movie I was thinking of? Either way it go, I want to do a big fence. Excuse me. Or a big something huge. Like a memorial, yes, but I want to be able to travel with it, and like, cause there's people that's not in Oklahoma anymore. I want to be able to take it with me and travel with it, so they can put whatever they want on it. So it's gonna be like a traveling memorial. I want to do that. And I know it probably sounds corny, but not everybody's in Oklahoma anymore. Not everybody wanted to do their time and still stay the fuck out here where the police probably recognize they motherfucking ass, or, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, some of them can't even travel. You know what I mean? Some of them, they just can't. So, I love to travel. I don't have any kids, you know? And my wife loves to travel too, so we can be the traveling wall memorial. See? Yes. And then I could find some people to interview out there. You know what I mean? I could find something to do out there. Like, we love to travel. So, y'all don't get it twisted. If you anywhere in the U.S. of A, we do need to have a reunion, y'all. What y'all think about that? But I'm going to tell y'all this. I ain't gonna do it. Y'all already know. Don't play with me. Don't. Now, if this reunion end up like the motherfucking, what reunion? Would it be the motherfucking, whose reunion do they be fighting at all the time? Is it the Bad Girls Club? I don't fucking know. All I know is it's a TV show that I be seeing like little snippets of on TikTok and shit. But all I know is this. Let's not do that, ladies. We're grown. But if we do, let's just not. Let's just not. Right. Look, I got the venue if y'all want to come to Oklahoma City. I'll pay for the whole venue if y'all want to come to Oklahoma. If y'all can make y'all way to Oklahoma City, we can do it in Oklahoma City. But if y'all want to choose somewhere else, fine. But if we do it in Oklahoma City, because that is technically kind of where Mabel Bassett was kind of by. So, if y'all want to, I'll get the venue. And y'all just tell me what date is good for everyone to travel. If y'all want to, we could plan for next year. Yeah, we could plan for next year. No worries, I'm not tripping. So, y'all, if you just now tuning in, that's my cat. If y'all just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. Y'all, I gotta change the subject a little bit. I will get back to these names, but I was not expecting to be, this was not my intentions. Look, I seen mascara drizzling down and shit. Yeah, that was not my intentions. I didn't even take no shrooms, and I'm not on my period. These is just real emotions, like. Y'all, let me tell you something. It's times where I do take shrooms, and I really believe that my friends are sending me messages. I don't give a fuck how you looking at me right now behind your phone, because you behind your phone. You ain't doing it to my face, pussy. I'm just kidding. But for real, I know you heard me crying. Aww. She's so sweet. Yeah. It ain't no fucking limits, right? It gotta be a limit to these tears, because I was not expecting that. I was expecting to be like, y'all, let me tell you about how this one girl. No. But I will tell y'all this. This is a funny story. I'm changing the subject real quick. So, I'm not gonna say her name,
But if you was on the yard with me, then you already go know exactly who I'm talking about. So there was this one time that this girl came to the yard, and some people would say that I used to take people's women, but tomato, tomato, get the fuck on. Anyways, so the girl hit the yard, and she hit the yard, and she said she ain't had no woman, right? Okay, cool. You said you didn't have no woman. This girl said you her woman. But if that's what you said, then guess what? Hey, I don't give a fuck. So, and she was a stud. So, y'all know how studs is. So, I'm like, you know what? Meet me in your room. Meet me in your room. She was like, okay. So, I get to her room. And I pull down her little boxes. Now, mind you, she ain't been on the yard that long, so these boxes gotta be kind of like new, right? Nah. These motherfuckers had like, I was like, did you spill Dr. Pepper in between your, right there? Because it was like a brown type of, like a, I don't know how to explain that part, but all I know is this. I had to take it up and just investigate. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to know what it was. Because it could have been easily, it could have been period blood. All right, cool. I got my red wings. But that's not what it was. I was like, are you aware that there is doo-doo in your boxer briefs? Now, we ain't gonna do it this time. I'm going to wash these bitches out real good for you just so I can show you how clean they can get. You feel me? So I'm going to clean these bitches up. I'm going to be back tomorrow. And I'm going to need that wolf to be clean too. And that booty hole too, because I think that's what left the stain. So, needless to say, she tried to go around saying that we had already did it, which we didn't even get to do it just yet. But I'm just like, why would you, you know I have to clean your drawers. Like, that's what I was doing. Like, I literally was, I didn't even get a chance to finish rinsing the motherfucker out before they was like, ah, girl, you was eating that pussy. Not yet, but I will. Like, what you mean? I didn't do it just yet. Yes, you did. That's what that motherfucker said. And I was like, why would you say that? And she just, I was like, you know I was cleaning them dirty ass fucking Dr. Pepper in the middle ass drawers. Like, what are you talking about? Like, why are you trying to lie and make it like, well, we ended up fucking like later on down to 33rd. But I was just like, why would you do that? Because they was pressuring me. I don't like to be pressured. So I just needed, I said all of that to tell y'all that pressure is a motherfucker on the yard. Pressure is a motherfucker. Okay? And if you can't handle the pressure, and if you can't handle the heat, stay the fuck up out the kitchen. I'm just saying. They will, listen, a motherfucker will have you in the motherfucking hole. They will. Trying to have you prove some shit. And you gonna try to prove it just because you on the yard. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? You gotta make yourself known. You know what I mean? Like, so sometimes you probably do some shit that you probably wouldn't have did in the world or that you ain't never had no business doing. I'm just saying. See, let me tell you something about me. One thing I love about me is I didn't give a fuck if I didn't have not a no friends. I don't give a fuck if I didn't have no friends. I'm I'm going to stand up for what I believe in, and I'm going to be who the fuck I am. Oh, my goodness. It was a time where there was this girl on the yard, which y'all know who she is, and we cool now, but she hated my guts. She hated my guts because she swore up and down I wanted to be with her wife. You know what I'm saying? So every day she would try to fight me, and I'd just be laughing. She'd be like, ah, stop laughing. Ah, stop smiling. It used to make her so mad. And I used to just be like, like, you know, and I knew she liked rides. So anytime she would do something like try to throw her coffee in my, you know, my area or in my face or anything. Like one time she threw it and it, I think it landed like in my hair or something. I was like, is that 800 milligrams of rods? Capsules. Oh, wasted. Thank you, though. Thank you so much. Have a good day. She just started screaming because she realized that she actually did just throw her rods that she just dumped in her coffee. And it landed all in my hair. I was like, y'all, something was really wrong with me. It really was. I didn't give a fuck. I used to be like, nah, I'm trying to get home. I'm not going to fight you in the yard. But what I will do is I will allow you to swing on me. And I'm going to matrix that ass. You're going to think you hit me. I don't give a fuck. I'm a... Yes. And I'm going to be on the ground. And you're going to be in lock. And I'm going to be out here with your woman. So that's why they was getting the feeling of me taking a woman. But it really wasn't that. It was really like a mind fuck thing. Like, hey, 30 days you'll be in lock. And I'm going to be out here with your woman the whole time. We'll be hitting the door for you. Okay. Yeah, something was truly wrong with me. I mean, because you kind of get them with their own game. It's like, okay, cool. We could fight all day, but whether I whoop your ass or you whoop my ass, guess what? You're still going to want to fight. So instead of that, let me just let you sit yourself down for 30 days. And you're going to be mind-fucking yourself, like, what's she out there doing with my woman? And even if I'm not doing anything, guess what? I'm going to intentionally go see your woman every day just to make it look like we are doing something. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. That's how I was on the yard, y'all. Because, come on now, don't. I'm going to hit you where it hurt. You trying to hit me? And you think that this hurt? No. Please. My daddy used to beat me in my face. Punch me in my face. Until I went to DHS custody. You think I give a fuck about getting punched in the face? A busted lip? Half my motherfucking middle school was busted lips. Stop it. I don't care about that. I've had black eyes. From family. Do you think that one little silly little girl is no. Mm-mm. Mentally, I'm a lot stronger. You know how they say in the Bible, if a man slaps your left cheek, you give him the other cheek to slap. I wouldn't mind doing that because in the long run, I'm going to have the last laugh. Yeah. Thank God for growth, though, you know? It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I'm just so glad that I'm not like that no more because, one, don't nobody be trying to taunt nobody like that no more. That was kid shit that people was on. Like, being in prison reminded me of, like a big-ass school. A big-ass school was, like, there was people, like, really, like, gangbanging. Like, girl, how did you get on? Like, who put you on? You better have been born into that motherfucker because some of these people really be capping. I'm just saying. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. Make sure you follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok. Couch Chronicles No Limits on Instagram and my main YouTube and Instagram, which is THA Real JANELL. And you can also visit my .com. It's the same. It's the same. Now, I am going to play a song and then I'm going to get back into the list. Because, one, I do have a few more names to name off. Also, y'all, make sure that you read the description because I don't always get to say everything. And check on your strong people. If you didn't get a chance today, just do it. Send them a text message. Send a mass text message to people. Like, check on your people. Just make a post. I did a wellness check on all of y'all. So if you didn't see, go to my post and let me know how you're doing. Because I did a wellness check. I want to know how everybody's doing. Also, May 14th is Mother's Day. I will be in Dallas, Texas. Shout out to Free Game Vane for booking me. I'm super excited. I'm actually headlining. So I'm going to be headlining in Dallas, Texas. And he will be bringing his tour out here in Oklahoma City. So all artists tap in. It's called the, what is it called? I think he ended up calling it the Change On Me Tour. So it's the Change On Me Tour. It says, why don't I have a stars option? I thought I did, but maybe I didn't. Maybe it's on my other page. I don't know. Somebody sent me some stars the other day, I thought. Maybe it was my other page. So I'm going to try to get it active. Also, you guys, if you would like to be on the couch and you want to be on the couch for Prison Talk, or if you just want to be on the couch to talk about your business or something that you're doing in life, anything, I don't care. You could be a teacher. You could be an asshole. You could be somebody that just wants to talk about, I don't give a fuck. Book with me. I'm your girl. Just DM me. Serious inquiries only. I cannot stand when somebody DMs me and they be like, yo, I'm trying to get on the couch. What's the ticket? I send them the stuff. And they like, all right, I'm going to holler at you in like 2 months. 2 months? Nigga, you should have hollered at me in 2 months then. Fuck right now. What you future pimp? Nah, nigga, this ain't no window shopping. Fuck on. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I'm like, what are we doing? And then it don't matter because the date that I tell you, 9 times out of 10, if you don't book it right then and there, it's going to be booked by somebody else. I'm not going to save that date just because I mentioned it for you. No. First come, first serve. I'll be like, yo, I got such and such open. They be like, all right, I'm going to holler at you in a few days. Okay. And then whenever they finally holler at me and that day is gone, they like, yo, hey, is it my turn? No, it's not. You didn't book. You don't even have a flyer yet. Oh, man.
I'm gonna start this one off a little bit low. And then I'm gonna come off a little high. Yeah. I know somebody gonna feel me on this motherfucker. This pretty eyes on this bitch. And I'm about to fuck it up. Yeah, I was born for this. I made it through the storm for this. And I always wanted more like this. And I see that they be watching. But they really not supporting shit. But it's okay cause I'ma make a way. I done been down for the count with all them lonely days. So I'm used to gray skies and rainy days. And I know some people tired of what I'm spitting, but I spit it till I fade away. Promise I done had some crazy days. My life's a movie you can see in no commercials or no lazy ways. This ain't the life that I chose, but I want more for it. The only reason why I handle it is cause I'm chose for it. Nah, for real, nah, for real.
Nah, for real.
I'm just saying. That's the only reason why the fuck I can handle this shit. I was born for this. I made it through the storm for this. And I always wanted more like this. And I see that they be watching. But they really not supporting shit. I was born for this. I made it through the storm for this. And I always wanted more like this. And I see that they be watching. But they really not supporting shit. But I got my name still rings bell, so I am a problem. If you do not come correct, just don't bother. I will not stop, I'm a guest, that's the options. For real though. That's the motherfucking options. I'm all gas and no motherfucking brakes.
Why?
Yeah, cause it's the life for me. I was born for this. I made it through the storm for this. And I always wanted more like this. And I see that they've been watching. But they really not supporting shit. I was born for this. I made it through the storm for this. And I always wanted more like this. And I see that they be watching.
But they what?
But they really not supporting shit.
Man. Okay. Y'all already know what time it is. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no motherfucking limit. If you watching on YouTube, make sure you hit the like button. If you watching on Facebook, make sure you share the live. Share the live. We still got time. Stop playing with me. It's prison talk for the rest of the week. If you want to talk, hey, Country Montana just hit the motherfucking live. He will be on the couch for prison talk this Thursday. Make sure y'all follow and support him as well. Y'all got love, support, good vibes, and positive energy. And that's all we trying to spread, right? Y'all already know what time it is, man. Let me take another sip and let me get back to this list. Y'all, I'm trying. Hope, here's to not crying. I ain't trying to cry no more. I'm talking about boogies just. We ain't trying to do all that. Okay. Danny Prevet. I think it's Prevet. Is it Prevet? Sorry, y'all, if I said that wrong. Shonda Jefferson, Patrice Stovall, Linda Stringer, Melissa Edwards. Oh, my God. Now, let me ask y'all this. If I'm not mistaken, didn't Brandy Meacham pass away? Or did I get that wrong? Because I'm not wishing death on nobody, and I'm not trying to call that on nobody. That's not what I was doing. But if I'm not mistaken, I think she passed away. And Dion Norman, and do y'all remember Link? Well, that was the last person I was going to mention as well. Now, it was a young lady that passed away when I was locked up. I can't remember her name. But she passed away from lupus. And she found out that she had lupus, and then the next week she passed away. Does anybody remember her name? I can't remember her name, but I know she was a black lady. And it was like around the time when I had first hit the yard. She was already in like medical. She didn't feel well. They was doing tests. And then when they found out, it was like once they told her, like a week later, like she literally passed away. And then like that was before I even found out that I had lupus. So maybe that same year, I think it was in 2009 that she passed away, actually. Because in 2009, that's when I found out that I had lupus. And actually, I take that back. I didn't find out technically, but the doctors knew that I had lupus. Yeah, they knew in 2009. So that was Mabel Bassett. I didn't find out to the end of 2014 that I had lupus. And all that time, they was telling me that, oh, your girlfriend is beating you up. That's why you're in pain. That's why you got those bruises on you. Nothing's wrong with you. And they was putting me on psych meds and putting me in therapeutic seclusion. And I was just really thinking, like, oh my God, like, I'm really fucking losing my mind. I was like, it gotta be because I'm in prison. I've never been here before. So my mind is like, I don't know. I was trying to make myself believe that the doctors was telling me the truth, because I really thought that they was telling me the truth. I never imagined that a doctor would be lying to me until I grew up and I went through some shit. And so I didn't realize that. I was just like, damn. When I found out, I was like, and how long have I had this? And when I finally got my records, it said that they knew. I was like, what? So put me on psych meds and call me a motherfucking liar instead of giving me the right medication and just trying to help. Yeah, so it blew my motherfucking mind. Just the whole... just the whole fact that... ugh. They don't give a fuck. And matter of fact, I think this Friday, I'm going to drive to Official Sports Bar and Grill, and I'm going to interview the owner again, because she was actually one of the medical nurses at Mabel Bassett. And she has a lot to say. So, yeah. And we might be doing her interview early, because I know she has to work. So, if you don't get to catch it, don't even trip. If you don't get to catch it, just go rewatch it. But I'm probably going to do it maybe like around like a lunchtime or some shit. Because a lot of times when she gets really busy at night, and my podcast is from like 8 to 9 typically. So I don't want to be rushed, because I'm going to have some good questions. And if any of you ladies recognize her, feel free. Even if she, this is the thing. It ain't no fucking limits on this podcast, and that's my girl. But if you was locked up and she was a nurse there when you was there, and she was mean to you, I want y'all to keep it real. I want y'all to all be honest and open if you remember her. You know, but she got some shit to say. She got some shit to say. I'm super excited. I'm excited because that is going to be like that's going to be a whole nother level. Like, it's different hearing it from an inmate, but y'all about to hear it from an ex-staff member. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I can't wait, because I got a little taste of what's about to be said. Whew. And I was like, oh yeah. Yeah. That's something else. But I'll tell y'all this. Some of the things that we think, we not wrong. About the medical system, we not wrong at all. For real. Some of the things that we think, like, is going on, is really fucking going on. And I will say this. She was there when Amber Hemberling, she didn't say died. She said got murdered. That's all I'm gonna say. Like, we talking about from a nurse that possibly was one of the ones that had to go check her body and all of that. Okay? Yes. We definitely was the guinea pigs to experiment on. Yeah. So, she got some shit to say about that case as well. So, y'all better tune in this Friday. I'm telling y'all, it's gonna get real deep. And fuck who get offended. For real. Cause y'all already know it's the Couch Chronicles and there ain't no fucking limits. Dead ass. Like. I'm ready for it, because it's a lot of stuff. It's a lot of questions that I specifically wanna ask, because I done been fucked over by their medical system plenty of fucking times. You know what I'm saying? And it's stuff that, yeah, right. Yes. So if y'all have any questions, any specific questions that you would like for me to write down, DM me your question and I'll write it down. And I will ask her this Friday. So even if you don't get to catch it right when I'm live, that way, you know, in case you wanted to ask a question. If there's a question that you would like to ask for this Friday for the nurse staff, I'm not going to say her name just yet. Just DM me your question and I will write it down. Because I write down my questions. Okay? So I will definitely be writing it down. Yeah. Hey. This Thursday, like I said, we got Country Montana. And if there's any other person that wants to tap in on a live, because if I'm not mistaken, he's in New Orleans. Oh, I hope I'm right. Watch it be New Jersey. But he is going to be doing his over the live, so y'all make sure that y'all tune in. Okay? Because it's definitely going down. Y'all, I love y'all. You said, do they get... Okay, yes. Okay, look. DM me that. DM me that same question so I can write it down. I'm about to write down some questions, actually, right now, because I need to write down some questions for Thursday. Oh, actually, tomorrow's Wednesday. Tomorrow's my day off. I got you. DM me, girl. Okay. Y'all, it's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. I will be back on Thursday. Like I said, prison talk again. And we're going to be on with Country Montana. I will see y'all this Thursday. I love y'all. It's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. Y'all have a good night. Ew. Ew.